I think there's much greater developments that people kind of overlook. They kind of think, oh, Lincoln, oh, the cathedral, oh, the university development. You're kind of missing the sort of wider picture. So I think there's much more to be explored in Lincoln.
Lincoln, a city thriving with business, education, beauty, and most of all, diversity. Diversity is everywhere, whether it's people, vehicles, but most of all, architecture. Over the past few weeks, we have captured some of the most spectacular acts of engineering, ranging from the cathedral, castle, and ruins, over to the much more modernized university campus. We have been lucky enough to speak with university architecture lecturers and students. This helped us to discover more about what inspires architects and also previous events in Lincoln involving architecture. We begin our journey at the summit of Steep Hill, where history grows from the ground, attracting tourists from all around the country, travelling far and wide to catch a glimpse of the beautiful structures. The construction of the Lincoln Cathedral first began back in 1185 and took 126 years until the final completion took place. In 1211, the building was crowned the tallest building in the world, and held this honour for 238 years before the central spire collapsed in 1549 due to an earthquake. The cathedral is now 272 feet tall and 470 feet in length. We were lucky enough to speak with Andy Earle, a university architecture lecturer who has been involved in recent events in the cathedral.
Hi, I'm Andy Earle. I'm a senior lecturer in architecture here at the Lincoln School of Architecture and Design. Now, I've been teaching architecture for the last 20 years here in Lincoln and before that in Hull. And before teaching, I was a practitioner of the art, and started when I was a student myself, doing small-scale projects with local communities, and then after qualification that became my career, and I've been privileged this year to have quite a lot to do with the cathedral through the Lincoln Labyrinth Festival, which was held in the cathedral over the month of August, and myself and a team of students from the school here drew the big chalk labyrinth on the floor of the nave of the cathedral. That was the centrepiece for the festival's activities. We also built a contemplation hut, a couple of students here won a competition and designed to design a contemplation hut to be built inside the cathedral. They built it here in our workshops as a prefabricated units, and then erected it inside the cathedral.
While we were at the university, we took the opportunity to film some of the more modernised areas of Lincoln. This included the main campus building, the engine shed event venue, and also the incredible architecture campus building. We spoke with two students who are aspiring architects. We wanted to find out more about the minds of those who will someday be designing the structures that surround us, and what inspires them.
I'm Dan. I study BI architecture. The building that really got me hyped and inspired for architecture was when I was doing a family trip down in London quite a few years ago now. And we were doing all the tourist things that tourists do. And we were going up towards the House of Parliament, which in itself is a very nice building, but I'm not really bothered by it. But to the right of the House of Parliament is another building. And I googled it at the time, and it's called Portcullis House. And you never actually see it in any of the photographs of the House of Parliament, but it's just the one right next to it. And it's got these great lines going up and like these tiny chimneys that are kind of reminiscent of the Battersea Power Station that's also in London. And it was actually 6 months later, I actually got onto this tour and I was like, yeah, I want to make this. This is what I want to do.
Hiya, I'm Rob. I'm an architecture student and I've been studying for just over 4 years now. I'm currently working on a cinema in the city of Ely, which is one of the smaller cities in England. I'm designing a 5-screen cinema, and it will have a restaurant and a green roof, which will have great views over to the cathedral, similar to Lincoln over here. I have two favourite architects. They're really different though. I have the very common answer of Zaha Hadid, which is a Middle Eastern London architect. She designs really, really modern, wavy buildings, like really, really futuristic, like curved and not straight walls, something you'd imagine to be something like a spacecraft. She's very futuristic. Just architects in general who are really different. I'm fed up of the traditional standard architects, and I think we need to move on and be a bit more creative. Yeah. If there's any point in designing a building that's not going to draw people to it, we might as well design a building that's going to be a local landmark and interesting, and people want to go inside. It's going to be different. So that's what I aim to do, and that's what these other architects I mentioned do.
Architecture is art, and these individuals are aspiring artists. A plot of land is a canvas, and the building materials are their paints. We found ourselves agreeing with much of the things that were being said, such as how modern buildings are very bland, whereas old buildings are beautiful. The future has a lot to hold where architecture is concerned, and I hope that aspiring architects such as these are the ones to rise to the challenge. Construction is always underway throughout Lincoln. Apartments, offices, and shops, constantly expanding the city and attracting more tourism. At the end of the day, this is what a city is supposed to be. Expansion is a factor that happens without us even noticing and usually takes time. But when it happens, it's always appreciated. This is where we end our short journey through Lincoln, and a big thank you to Lincoln University and Cathedral for allowing us the time to film your property and taking part in interviews. Don't forget, architecture is all around us. Every building, structure, model. Everything takes a lot of blood, sweat and tears, and for these reasons, we should learn to appreciate it all a lot more.